She sees me in person for the first time after 6-7 months,
mm-hmm.
and I'm bald.
Previously on Julius Bar.
Forgotten cocktails, I mean cocktails I never made again.
Ooh, there are a lot of them. Oh, this must be good. Last corpse.
Okay.
Cheers. I really like it. Interesting.
Is that right?
Okay.
Next one.
This becomes a hard
choice.
By the
way, 1910 was really excellent.
I think I need to do this, but I don't know how to pronounce this. Cygnus X1.
Ah, okay.
Wait, what language is this? Cygnus.
It's
X1.
Sounds like Latin to me.
Because it gives me some Japanese component in it.
Yes. Let's see if I can remember how to make this. So for this cocktail, we're gonna need pear juice. And I prepared some sliced up, really ripe pear already in this cup, which was really good because now I'm a bit drunk. And I don't think I could have done it.
Whoa! Oh!
I could have done it right now, slicing and peeling all the pearls. Sing X1, it's a song by Rush, but it's also the first black hole that was ever discovered and confirmed in the 1970s.
So which one is after this cocktail?
This one is after the Rush song, which is probably my favorite Rush song because it's so much heavier. So we're gonna need 40 milliliters of pear juice. Yeah, we can reach 40. Come on, we can do it. There you go. Thank you very much. Then we need 1 teaspoon of matcha powder.
This is the Japanese part.
I think now matcha powder should be pretty widely available around the world, so I don't feel it's that big of a deal. Anyway, as you can see in my original video, I think I got the inspiration from Bar Libre in Ikebukuro, which is an excellent bar here in Tokyo. And I'm just gonna try to dissolve all the matcha powder in the pear juice using this alcohol distill.
Mixer? No.
Shaker? Blender? I don't know what's called.
Former.
It's a former, yes.
It's the one to make the milk form.
Which actually is a technique I learned from Bar Libre in Ikebukuro. It's a really good technique if you want to keep your drinks short and not too diluted. Instead of adding simple syrup to cocktails, you add powdered sugar and then you use this thing to shake. And we do a lot in Bar Libre Ikebukuro, which is, again, an excellent bar here in Tokyo. So we're gonna put the contents of this mixing glass in a shaker. Then we're gonna need 1 teaspoon of elderflower liqueur. For me it's Saint Germain because probably there are other elderflower liqueurs, but I didn't get down that rabbit hole yet. And then 60 milliliters of the possibly fresh pisco. I love pisco, and there are different kinds of pisco that are different as different kind of wines. Pisco, in that sense, is amazing because it's distilled only once, it keeps the flavor of the grapes. And in this case, I chose Tonnontel, which is closer, I think, to a Chardonnay or something like that. Drier and less fruity than the Quebranta.
Where is it originally from, pisco?
From Peru. There's also a pisco in Chile, but Chile is less regulated and a bit more of a wild card. Chile's pisco is not exported much, and I don't know anything more about it. For me, pisco is Peru. If you're Chilean and you like your pisco, send me a bottle, then we can talk about it. So let's get some price in our shake. Let's give this bad boy a shake. And let's pour it.
You looked everywhere.
I completely forgot
that so
I was chilling this. And we are gonna pour it over it. And that's gonna be a Sinus X1 pear and matcha. And again, you go first.
I have to have it like a
tea
ceremony, like a very traditional Japanese tea ceremony, because like the cup and also inside matcha really reminds me of that traditional way.
By the way, I made this cup in my really brief career as a pottery maker.
Yeah, handmade.
Before our son was born. Oh, around the time our son was born. Yeah, when I quit because our son was born and we needed a bit more time at home.
For a second, I didn't even think this is an alcoholic drink.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
It's very zen.
Let me try it. Let's see. Yeah, good is good. There is a deepness of flavors that goes a long way.
Like a forest-like.
Yeah, that's a good comment. You have to be ready for new experience. It's so different from the... Actually, this is really good in the sense of Japanese. It's so Japanese.
Mm-hmm. It's deep, like calm.
I mean, matcha has a strong bitterness to it. And there is a much sugar in this drink because there is one teaspoon of elderflower, which is the only thing slightly sweet.
Okay. I think you can just serve this as like a proper... like a tea ceremony, and nobody would doubt it.
Or it would be a great drink
after dinner. After.
In a Japanese kaiseki.
Kaiseki.
Kaiseki thing.
Yes.
Like a proper Japanese, really serious hardcore, which actually we don't enjoy very much. But.
Yes.
Yeah. This could be like the end.
Yes, end. I think end is better.
And because it's really bitter, it's gonna help you digest all the sashimi you had in the dinner.
It's not too powerful. It's very calm.
It's
present.
The pear. The pear juice really mellows everything out.
Okay. That's very nice. I can imagine myself drinking this in like Kyoto.
Okay, time to choose the next drink.
I'm gonna cross off. Sinus X1. Check! Now, can I go back to my favorite gin?
Yep.
Oh my holy, there's a lot of ingredients in this thing. I'm gonna go with the name because I like this name. Pink Lady.
Okay.
Today I'm a red lady, but I also like pink too these days. Oh my god, pink used to be my least favorite color.
Okay, so let's gather the ingredients. So we had a bit of a camera problem, but we are back. And let's get down to mixing this Pink Lady Miramar Club Panama version. So, first of all, egg white. Can you get the salt?
Salt.
Can you put a pinch of salt here?
Oh my god, Rocky!
It's really good actually. Okay, we have our egg white in here. Then 2/3 of a teaspoon of absinthe. Let's see, 2/3 of a teaspoon.
Okay, that's egg coming back at you.
Yeah, it's the salt. Okay, then 7.5 milliliters of grenadine syrup. I'm just gonna put an overflowing teaspoon, then 22.5 milliliters of lemon juice from the one we squeezed before, yes. 22.5 milliliters of dry vermouth. 45 milliliters of slow gin. The sweet gin
slow.
Infused with slow berries, and it's sweet. We add sugar to this stuff. 26% ABV. And then autumn gin, also 45 milliliters. Okay, let's give this bad boy a shake with some ice.
Your tongue is out.
Effort. Tongue for effort. Can you get the flanged coupe?
This one?
Yes, that one. Mm. Yeah, we need this because we have...
I don't think I can raise that glass.
Yeah, this glass, it keeps a bit more volume than the other ones. And I remember this being a pretty big cocktail. Because he has 45 and 45 and 20, yeah, he has a lot of stuff in it. And there you go, a Pink Lady Miramar Club from Panama. Panama! Edition. Please.
But I really cannot raise it. It's...
Wait, you can go down.
Whoa!
Is it good or bad?
I thought it was a really strong punch. But then egg white kind of makes it milder.
Mmm. It's good.
Mmm.
It's kind of nutty. I don't know why. Why would it be nutty? From ingredients we've seen, you wouldn't expect nutty.
No.
I think it's a slow gin.
And then you think it's like the first sip, like, whoa, strong. You can taste a lot of alcohol. But then the egg white makes it like, huh.
Yeah, more mellow.
Mellow, yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
It's dangerous.
Yeah, it's one of those dangerous ones. It's also a lot of drink. It's proportion like old-time drinks. You should really make 2/3 of this drink will be a normal amount. Yeah, I think this is a big drink. Yeah, good to share with two people.
In Japan, back in, I don't know which year, 70s or 80s, there was a duo ladies, idol, called Pink Lady.
Pink Lady?
Hmm.
Well, Pink Lady was the girls that become friends with...
Who? You don't need so much suspense. Who?
Country Road. I'm mixing Panama and Country Road in my head.
Too much alcohol.
Yes, and I cannot understand. The lady, Grease, Olivia Newton-John, Sandy, it's her name.
Sandy.
Yes, her buddies, they are the pink ladies.
Ah, yes, they were wearing like a pink... How to call it, the Yokosuka jacket,
yeah.
Which is not Yokosuka jacket in that term, but...
Yeah, what's the deal with a Yokosuka...
Ska jan. It's called Ska jan.
Yeah, but what is it? Explain to people who have never heard of it.
It's in Kanagawa Prefecture, where we also have a Navy, US Navy base.
Right next to Yokohama?
Yes, close to Yokohama. And so they have a culture of kind of US... Japan mix in a way, and this is a fashionable item. It's like a zip up jumper, like a jacket,
really,
but
like
very colorful
and really acrylic. It's really
synthetic
film.
Like vivid colors, and then
tiger stuff like that.
Yeah
so
from
like
Yokosuka is the name of the
place. And
jumper, like
which zip.
Zip up.
It become Yokosuka, you just get the suka and
jan.
And jan from jumper. And it's called Ska-jan.
Yes.
Is it in the US where you have varsity jacket or something like that? What's varsity?
Like university versus, usually they use it in a sports term. Like
the cheaper. Italian high school is a bit longer.
Exactly the same.
No tattoo. This much is... Time to choose the next drink.
All right. Wait, I get to do the
Pink Lady Miramar Club. Yay! Panama.
Sense of completion.
Actually, we are down to 5 drinks.
Is it too easy? But I try to feel like something simple.
Yeah.
This one. Old Pal Classic.
Rye Whiskey Driver Muff and Campari. Sure.
But simple, but very strong.
Yeah, that's a serious drink, I would say.
Yes.
So that and dry vermouth, which is already here.
Okay.
And that's it. Okay, let's start with 30 milliliters of dry vermouth. Then 30 milliliters of Campari. I mean, this is another really easy recipe.
Again, why you didn't do it again?
Yeah, why I never make this?
Too easy? Doesn't challenge your skill? Doesn't feel like you push to the next level of your...
I mean, it's simple, but it also pretty strong. It's basically a Negroni variation served straight up. And you substitute the bourbon
with rye whiskey.
Exactly. And sweet vermouth with dry vermouth. So it's a lot drier.
Okay, I didn't read that part.
So it's more dry and more spicy than a normal Negroni. It's also served straight up, I think. This is good.
But if it's like too strong, can't you differentiate by how you dilute with the ice?
Yeah, you can dilute a bit more, but then it's gonna be kind of lame. It's not gonna be as good. I think this one, actually, from the spoon taste I had, is pretty. Let's get a bit more water. I think probably orange peel would be perfect here.
That's a beautiful color, this cocktail.
Yeah, Campari is amazing. You must wonder, like, people, they invented Campari
back in long time ago.
I don't know when. In a way, it's insane. It's so sharp, so spicy, so bitter, but it works. Please have a first sip. So this is the Old Pal classic recipe.
Cheers. It's serious cocktail. I can imagine me having this maybe Thursday night.
Thursday night? what happens on Thursday night?
You know, usually like when you're... Okay, you cannot have this really strong, serious cocktail Monday to Wednesday because you have more days to go on. Thursday's like, okay, I can do it one more day. But then Friday, you want to be more like a party mode, so not too serious. This is okay. I am going to just sit here, think about what I'm going to do tomorrow.
And have one.
Yeah.
You're going to have one drink. Only one drink. It's going to be this. Yeah, I can see that. That's a good...
Yeah.
Wow, this is good.
But I must warn you, if you cannot take much alcohol, this is very strong. So...
Yeah. It's a stiff drink. It's like a martini. Like,
yeah.
You should know what you're getting into.
This just one or two sips might knock you out. Depending on how much alcohol you can take in.
Well, it's really good.
Yeah.
It's funny because the sweetness that's underlying the cocktail, it's really coming from the Campari. And the Campari, it's sweet. It has a good chunk of sugar in it. But normally I would just associate it with spices, not with sugar. I don't think I can get it straight anymore.
Okay, this is going to be our last drink for tonight.
Really?
You know what? Next time I'm going to choose the most complicated one and see if you can even make it right.
Yeah. We should at least one more. I think we are not done yet. PG-13. No, I'm fine.
What?
What?
Just, you know, the thing. And
who cares? For blood.
First, I get to do the check-off. Old Pal.
Done.
And then, finally, but not the least, because he's so drunk, it's going to be very interesting to give him the most difficult cocktail. And when I say most difficult, it's just a lot of ingredients, which is one drink to roll them all.
Okay, I can do it. No problem, Mignon.
A few minutes later.
So let's start squeezing some orange juice. So, one drink to rule them all. It's a drink I made one night where I was drunk as this. And I just threw everything in the shaker and I just made a drink and it turned out to be really good. So I made a video. And I guess we are at the same point tonight. Orange juice, 15 milliliters. 1 teaspoon of brown sugar. Actually, nowadays I will skip this part and go straight to my simple syrup. I make the simple syrup with some brown sugar too, so that will be fine. But because I have here the foamer, which I'm gonna need, so I'm gonna use a foamer. Why don't do that back? Why don't you vacuum here?
I'm gonna vacuum you too. And come back.
15 milliliters of orange juice.
No, you already put the...
I already put it? Ah, yeah.
And this is exactly why I chose this one at the end. When he's so wasted, what's gonna come out? From now on,
Okay, 4 dashes of Angostura. 1, 2, 3, 4. No, it was just a small. It was a bit small dashes, so I put a bit more.
And you put back the thing. You never put back the other things. You put back the bitter.
Apricot brandy. So this is not actually cuisinière. It's a blend. And this cork, I don't know if it's...
It's not the cool. It's Mister.
It's screw on. Okay, this is actually a blend. I said in some videos before.
Oh my god.
It's not like the cuisinière. It's like basically cuisinière plus apricot brandy plus a plum brandy I have from Japan, which is really dry. Anyway, this is not cuisinière. I don't even know if it's distributed.
What's it, cuisinière?
Yeah, but you know, I think it's
only.
I think it's only in Japan. Anyway, this cup doesn't go on anymore.
No, you're just too drunk.
Wait, so what point we are in the recipe? Wait, orange juice I already put. Brown sugar I put.
No, you didn't put the orange juice.
What did I put? I put orange juice. I didn't put orange juice?
No.
So this is, what's this? Okay, I can put orange juice. Are you sure? I trust her. She's less drunk than I am. No, but what I'm doing, I'm not measuring. Amaro nonino. I got it. Oh, this stuff is... you know, inflation, Ukraine war, all the stuff. Prices in Japan have gone up the ceiling. It's insane. And this stuff now is cost more than 5,000 yen. And I'm not planning on buying it anytime soon. So this is like gold, not right now.
When you go back to Italy next time.
Yeah. In Italy, this stuff is so cheap. It's insane. It's like 14 euro or something.
So it costs like 4 times more here.
Oh my god, it's crazy. Carpano dry. 22.5. Sweet vermouth. Also 22.5. Dry gin. And we're gonna use Stranger and Sons that my wife got from India.
This is a really beautiful gin.
It's really versatile.
I really wish I can buy it here. It's not distributed here in Japan.
I'm buying 22.5 of Geneva. And...
Oh, It sounds like my fitness instructor. There's a part where we do the ducking, and he's like, and it makes me laugh all the time.
Yeah, I played soccer like 3 hours 2 days ago, and I'm still recovering. He's freaking good. Let's get some ice. Okay. Give this bad boy a shake. Wow, it's a lot. Okay, it's not gonna fit.
Oh my god!
Can you get a shot glass?
I wonder why it's a lot more.
Well, it's a big drink that I made one night when I was drunk, so.
And again, the drunk night.
Yeah, but proportions are off. Ah! Oh no!
He's so drunk.
Never ending story. We watched it like a couple years ago, I think. Yeah. But it was so weird. Was it good? I don't know if it was good. It was really weird.
Cheers.
Cheers. Anyway, this is one drink to rule them all. Like, not in the Never Ending Story, but in the Lord of the Rings.
Can't raise a chin.
Chin. This is good.
Do you know why it's good?
Because we're drunk.
No? Because it has a double orange.
Double orange? Like how? Yes, orange juice and?
You put the double portion of orange juice.
I knew it! I was like, how did you put the orange? It's good. This is good.
This is how drunk you are. And the thing is, you tasted it. And then you were so determined. Yeah, I need to put oranges. No, but regardless of what he says, this is a really good drink.
Yeah. Okay, you can put either 50 milliliters or 30 milliliters of orange juice and you're going to be fine. I think the split between Geneva and gin is genius. Drunk genius, but genius nonetheless.
It's so funny how drunk you are. At least you're still happy drunk, you know? You're not sick drunk. This was fun.
Yeah. I think this is our last drink for today. Please like, share, subscribe. Do whatever you want. You're your own man. Or woman, or whatever. And hopefully, we will see you in the new year.
2024.
Yes. So, enjoy. Have a good year. Have fun. And we will be waiting for you to come back to our channel. Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Don't go too close.
I just wanted to show the color.
Yeah, go here.
But my
okay.
Thing go is over red. Me. Okay, I'm. Cheers.
Yeah, you have to point here.
Cheers.